Hi, this is Crystal, and this is episode 18 of Reseller Shop Talk. And in this episode, I'm going to talk a little bit about a haul that of goodies that I just purchased that I'm a little excited about. Some of them are pretty good. I think they should all sell. That's the important thing. Let's get started. So, first, let's start with this tree. I'm sure this was the first thing you noticed, and you're like, what is that? But this is, it's a little deer talking to a little cardinal, and with a pine tree. And I thought that somebody could use this in one of their Christmas village scenes with, like, those houses that you get at Walmart or those, shoot, what are they called? Something 55 houses, like those Christmas houses. Why can't I remember the name of those? Probably because I've never sold one. I have sold some from Mervyn's and some other ones, they don't, the ones that are not, I don't know, I want to say Pier 55 or Studio 55, those tend to do better. I'll have to look that up. Anyways, but this, they also, you know, people will set them up and then they'll have little accessories around them. So I thought this could be something like that. And I have some other accessories like this that I made a lot with this, put them in a lot, or I may sell this separately. I don't know, but I think I can get at least 10. I may try to get 15 because it's actually really nice and charming and unique. And there's no brand on it as far as I can tell. I picked it up for 20% off of $3.99, so $2.99, no, that would be 25, like $3.20, $3.19, something like that. Okay, so again, not big money, but super easy to list. It's a Christmas item, and I've talked about this before, but if you're new to my channel, I love Christmas stuff because it sells at Christmas time, and people buy it, and I just like to make sure that I have things that sell at Christmas, and sometimes the clothing, at least the clothing that I have, or last Christmas, like maybe I didn't have enough, I don't know. It just wasn't selling, but my Christmas stuff was, and last Christmas I had really hoped to have more, and so I'm just going to keep plugging away all year long whenever I find Christmas things and get it listed, and so it's ready to go when Christmas hits. That's how I did it last year, but I just didn't get enough of it. So let's see, next thing, I guess we'll stick with the Christmas theme. This is another Christmas item I got. It is a snow globe with music. And it's got the little glitter in it. I probably should sit and listen to it all the way through to make sure it sounds okay. I haven't done that. I'm not even sure if that even sounds right. It doesn't sound like anything. Let's go all the way through. Somebody might buy it regardless. People like these snow globes. I've sold them before, even the cheapy ones, and this is a cheapy one. And I think it's actually kind of neat for what it is. It's Jesus. How much did you see Jesus with Mary and Joseph in a snow globe? Usually it's like a snowman or Santa Claus or a mermaid or something like that. A Christmas mermaid, you know. Because mermaids are so Christmassy. Yeah, I don't know. I think that music is a little off. I don't know. It's kind of sweet, though. So we'll see what happens. $10 for that, and I got it for $1. The purple tags were $1. I think this is the only thing on the table that I got on that's purple tag that I got for $1. I think some other things I got for less than $1. Just because they were so cheaply priced. So that's it for Christmas. You know, I'm going to put this back here because that way there's something to look at. You know, just not enough stuff to look at. Let's go off screen. Let's do another potential holiday. Now, I believe these things sell year-round, but this is Lily Munster or Lillian Munster. Is it Lily or Lilia? Or Lillian? Lillian, I think. Lillian Munster. And the Munsters seem to be pretty popular, seem to be actively selling. And if you have like a whole set of, you know, her and Eddie and Grandpa and Herman, you might be able to get like $40 or $50, maybe $60, just depending. I can't remember the exact prices, so just look it up, see what's going on. If you want to confirm what I'm saying is true. But I would certainly, if you come across any Munsters things, take a look at them. Now, she does need a little attention. Her cape is coming off, but I think she's likely to sell, and I got her for less than $1.80. So, and again, her alone, she might only sell for maybe 10 or 15, and she might sell better at Halloween. I don't know, but yeah, she's pretty cool. And she's not like a plastic, she's like a plush all the way through, except for her face and chest is plastic. So she's kind of interesting. But yeah, dig Lillian. Okay, here's another fun one. Lillian, is that even right, or is it Vivian? Now I don't even know if I know what her name is. Okay, I'll stop thinking about it. Okay, this is a little tiki, not tiki, well, I guess it's a tiki bar accessory. a little hula girl, and I just think her face is so happy. She has sort of an anime look to her, in my opinion, with the big white shine spot. But I like that her body, I should have taken this off, but her, I like the way her body is like twisted, and I think the skirt is really cool. It needs to be primped a little bit, and her hair kind of fixed up a little bit, and I love the lay. I just think it's really cute, and I probably need to do a few things to her hat. And I normally do not buy stuff like this that I gotta fix up, but I think I could get, I don't know how much these go for, but I'm going to try to get $20, unless there's just a million of her already listed and everybody's trying to sell them for $7. But I don't think so. And she doesn't have a name. Let me see. I guess if I didn't even bother looking. Oh, she has a little bikini. I don't see any kind of brand on her. Which could be a good thing, actually, because I think people will just like her. I think she's really cool. And I always have good luck with tiki stuff. Somebody was just saying that tiki stuff isn't doing as good as it used to, but maybe if they're trying to sell their tiki stuff for $50, $60, and they used to be able to get $50, $60, and now they're getting $25 or something for the same kinds of things they used to get more money for, then I guess it tanked. But if you're like me, and you don't really find super great tiki stuff all the time, you're finding average tiki stuff, and you're getting the $25, you're probably still going to get the $25, because people want it. I don't know. Who knows? And different, you know, maybe, I don't know. Now, this is a tiki, and it's wood carved, wood, solid wood, see? Now, I don't know what kind of wood it is. I am hoping that it is acacia. It's really interesting. This is an actual, what do you call that? A swirl in the wood. And then it, you know, it goes from light to like this darker color. Really interesting piece. I don't know. I wonder if they lightened it on purpose or stained it. Maybe they stained it. I don't know, but I think it's pretty cool. And I think the real wood tikis are better than, like, if you find, like, a resin one. or something that's made out of something else, a tiki that's made out of something else, unless it's, I don't know, something from Trader Vic's from 1950s or something. And then, unfortunately, there's like some glue here, so I don't know what was on there before. I don't know if I'm going to try to take that out or what, but I got him for half price. They wanted $5. I got him for $2.50. So, I don't know, maybe $30, $40, maybe more. I don't know. Whoa. Maybe, worst case scenario, $15. Okay, here is another one that I'm hopeful about and I haven't looked up, but I was on Cherry Vintage's channel, and she was doing a shop with me video, and she had seen some things like this and had mentioned that if they are plant holders, they are popular sellers. Now, I think this video that Cherry Vintage made was several years ago, so I don't know how the market is now, but I would imagine that these kinds of things are still collectible. There's still collectors for them, and you can still get decent money. I mean, I don't know. Now, this one, I believe that the ones that are probably the most valuable are the ones from the 50s or earlier, and I have a feeling this one might be 60s, maybe early 70s. It was made in Japan by Inarco, and I don't know the brand, but it's in great shape, and I think it's pretty cute. I mean, come on, koala bear. It's like always on the list of, whenever anybody makes a list of like the top 10 cutest animals on the world, koala bear is always on it. Like, they might have skipped, I don't know, the fox and put baby chick on there or something. You know, like those two animals, somebody might have missed them or whatever. They decided, no, the fox is cuter than the chick. And somebody's like, no, the chick is cuter than the fox. Let's just get rid of the fox or whatever. Like, I don't know. But koala bear is probably top three. Anyways, just my opinion about koala bears. Koala bear is always in my top three list. So, it's gonna sell. It's gonna be great. Here's another one I'm hopeful about. And again, I haven't looked these up. I think I can get at least 15, maybe 20, maybe 25. I don't know. But it says gold plated, 24 karat. And these are Austrian crystals. So we shall see. And I don't think there's a brand. There could be a brand under here. And I paid 20% off of that. What does that make it? Whatever 20% off $2.99 is. And this one I paid 20% off $1.99. I should know these numbers by now. Okay, here's another one that I don't know about, but I just had to get it. And it was 20% off $1.49. It's a bronze, like, old-timey clown shoe. Just super cute. Kind of heavy, make a good paperweight. I don't know. I just love it. Is it just me? But, again, I have no idea what the market's like. I did look up some bronze shoes, and I think it was, like, baby bronze shoes. And it didn't look like a good market, and I couldn't remember what the good ones were, so it'll be good for me to go back and do some research. But I think I can get at least $10 for that with calculated shipping. Okay, and then I got these little angels. Now, I saw this one first, and then I looked at the price. I'm like, $3.99, and it was when I first started shopping, and I'm like, yeah, I don't know. Like, it's cute, but I don't know. You know, $3.19. I don't know. Maybe I might get $10. I don't know if I bought it for 50 cents or $1 or $1.50, maybe, but not for $3.19. And then I saw this one around the corner. And I'm like, hey, that matches the other one. And, of course, they wanted $3.99 for this one, too. But I thought, you know what? They match. And white is really popular. And cherub angels are popular, and I think these are like the Michelangelo, or they're similar to like those Michelangelo angels that are like lounging. I don't know, that people have made like printed artwork pieces depicting those angels. I used to have a thing with those angels on them. I need to look it up and see how closely these resemble those Michelangelo angels. But I think the subject matter, the color, the size is good. I think these have a good chance of selling. Now, they did come from Cost Plus, and I'm assuming they wanted $12.99 each. You can kind of see that there's a PL there, so that's got to be Cost Plus. But it could have been $12.99 for the set, but I have a feeling it was $12.99 each. And I think I can get $20 for these. So that was worth $6.40, right? The important thing is they're going to sell, and I'm not going to lose money. I might have to spend a little more time packaging than I want to, but actually I'm a pretty fast packager. I've got a good system down. And I have a really good shipping. I have a really nice fulfillment center in my master bedroom that I'm really happy with. Well, there's a few things I'd like to do to make it better and more efficient, but when you have a good shipping area, it makes buying these types of things more appealing, where you don't think, do I want to really ship that? You know, is it? It's like, great, I might only make $10, but I know I can ship it really fast and easy. What else? Okay, then I've got these metal things over here. I've sold several of these hook things that are usually, typically, if they're unique. Again, I might only get $10 for this, but if somebody's looking for a hook and they want something different and unique, I always pick these up. They're so easy, and usually you can pick them up really cheap at the thrift stores. I got this for 79 cents, and I mean, you don't really have to say much about it. It doesn't take up a lot of space. It's just, everything's easy about it. So, again, it's like a $5 bill just laying there without hardly having to do anything. Now, these I love because they sort of have a rustic look to them, and I love this distressed look. And I was thinking I might do a lot of candlesticks. So I'm collecting candlesticks, and then maybe, you know, I'll do like a lot for when I get enough that I think I can get like $35 or $40 or even $50 or something, then I'll lot them together. And I know I've said this before, I don't like doing that, but I just find this stuff all the time, and I'm always like, yeah, I don't usually do good on like generic candlesticks. You know, there's just certain ones that are good, you know, and I just, so I don't pick them up, but I'm always like, those are so cool. And then I always think if you lotted them together. Anyways, I don't know. I'm going to make a space in my garage for certain things that can withstand the heat in the summertime. That, and of things that I'm like lotting together like that are going to take up a lot of space. So yeah, I got two of them. Here's the other one. See, two. Evidence that I have two. Yeah, and they're no brand. Ooh, they're kind of gross on the bottom. And they are just the those tapered skinny candles, which I don't think are as popular as the kind that can hold the pillar candles like this. Here's one that holds a pillar candle. And this one's all rustic, and it's like Texas Star rustic. So, again, I think I'm going to save it for a lot. I don't know. We'll see. But I just love them. So I have to pick them up. Oh, how much did I pay for these? $2.49. I think it was $2.49 each. But she might have only charged me for one. I'm just going to say she charged me for both, so let's just say $4. And for those two rustic ones. And this one, the thing fell off. Darn it. That's a bummer. $1.99, probably. $2.99, I don't know. It's a little lopsided. It's going to need a little attention. But cool, nevertheless. This one is Party Light. And I'm not real sure. I've been looking at Party Light, and I'm just starting to get to know them. But I really like this. People kind of like this. Sometimes they like this more formal. It's casual but formal at the same time, and then it's in the silver tone. I can't remember. Is this brush? It's kind of like brushed nickel with a sort of antiquing in the crevices. If you want to call it antiquing, I don't know the word for it. But again, it is just, it's for a tapered candle, unfortunately. But again, you know, people still like them and buy them. I just think the pillar candle holders are more popular. But what do I know? I'm not a candlestick selling expert yet. But I don't know if you can see that logo, Party Light. So we'll see. I've been finding a lot of Party Light lately, and some of the pieces I turned down because I'm just not sure about it, and I just don't think it's even worth looking up. But then every once in a while, I'm like, that's kind of nice. That could be like one of the more desirable Party Lights. So I'm learning that brand. And again, I haven't looked that one up. Now, these are, I looked up. Because I knew, they're Doc Martens. And they were $5 at a resale shop. And I've got the hookup. There's this resale shop right next to a thrift store. And they're both really great prices. And I love them. I gotta go into both. I'm just gonna start making a weekly trip to both of those places. And they're kind of close to my house. And then on the way back or on the way there, probably on the way back, then I hit up my favorite Goodwill that has like the best prices ever. They have way better prices than all the other Goodwills. Because they're kind of they're new. They just opened like less than a year ago, I think, or about a year ago. And they are in an area that, I don't know if poor is the right word, but it's like one of where the real estate is the cheapest, and there are a lot of low-income people, I guess is probably a more politically correct way to say poor, but it's just in an area that's sort of like a pocket of a lot of people with low incomes, basically, just the way it is, and it's in between sort of like an upper-class, middle-class area, and then another like heavy middle class with I'm sure quite a bit of upper class, and then tons of retirees. It's just in this middle spot right between my area and that other area, and it's a gold mine. And again, I'm gonna bring up Cherry Vintage. If you haven't seen the videos that Cherry Vintage has made, check them out. I love Cherry Vintage. She's no longer making videos. I think it's been 2-3 years since she's made videos, but the ones she's got up are still valuable. She's very knowledgeable, and I love the way she does her videos, and I like that chick. And she used to always be in the chats on Chad Pagel's channel a lot on Reseller Pulse. And some people have said, get Cherry Vintage on for an interview. Like, she's cool. Very cool chick. Wish she was still doing videos. Hope she's doing okay. If you happen to be watching my video, Cherry, I really, really appreciate what you've done for the reseller community. And I hope you always leave your videos up, because I think they're wonderful videos. And you're the best video maker. Producer. Okay, so let's get back to the Doc Martens. These are sort of like, I want to call them mauve, but they're a little on the pink side, and then they're sort of plum on the inside. I don't know if they're more purple than pink, or what I'm going to call them, but I think I'm going to call them purple, pink, mauve, plum. But there's nothing like these. And it seems like the unique ones tend to sell more. And there's some that are kind of, they have like, they're like floral pattern. And they're like Mary Jane style, like these. And those are going for like $45 with calculated shipping. So people are paying $50 up for the right Doc Martens. So I might try to get $50 for these. At least $45. And worst case scenario, you know, I'm positive they'll go for $35. Because that seems to be the average going rate for your everyday average brown, black, Mary Jane, Doc Martin. And I bought them for $5, so those were a no-brainer. And apparently, I have sold Doc Martens before, and they sold really fast, and I believe that these will too. Everybody says they still do, so I'm going to trust their word on it, and it looks like they're actively selling, so all the signs are there. Let's see, one more thing. This is a Sioux Indian pottery piece, art piece. It's probably something that was sold in a real touristy kind of area. But that doesn't matter, to tell you the truth. I live in Arizona. We, especially northern Arizona, there are a ton of places that have like the Navajo, Hopi, Zuni, and maybe some of the other Indians, Native Americans, they have artwork and all kinds of stuff is plentiful. And a lot of, you know, people go back and forth between New Mexico and Arizona, and, you know, my mom and her friends and her colleagues, like, everybody has this kind of stuff from the Native Americans in our area. And I think the Sioux, aren't those more like Oklahoma? I need to refresh my memory about Sioux Indians. But I love this. And I don't know if this is like super common for that tribe, this type of thing. Because sometimes like with the Hopi Navajo, like some things it's like, yeah, those are like a dime a dozen. I mean, they'll still sell. But if it's really unique, you're not, you know, I'm not going to go on eBay and go, there's a million things like almost exactly like this. Like, although even with Native American artwork, it usually there's not, it just, anyways, and I'm probably not going to get big money for it. Best case scenario, probably 20. Worst case scenario, like 12. But I'm going to go for like maybe a $16, $17 price on this. 14. I don't know. I gotta look it up, but it's a really nice piece. It's so pretty. And you don't see, I don't know, you don't see this blue so much with the Hopi Navajo stuff. I just like that. Anyways, so that's my haul. Oh, how much did I pay for it? I paid $3.99 minus, so what, $3.19. So, and again, the important thing is I know it's going to sell. Let's see. The things on the table that I don't know are going to sell. The shoe. I don't know if my bronze shoe is actually going to sell. I don't know for sure that this will sell. I just have a really good feeling that it will. This may or may not, you know what, I'm pretty confident this is going to sell, but it may not, I don't know. This party light candlestick, I don't know, because there could be like 100 of those listed. Sometimes certain things, it's like you think, oh, this is cool, and then you go on there and it's like everybody's selling it for $6. And you're like, well, I don't think I want to play that game. Okay. Yeah, I'm feeling really confident about this. Maybe it's the candlesticks I'm not real sure about, because again, I've sold candlesticks, but I've never really done all that fantastic with candlesticks. So let's see. Here's where the talking part comes in. I am hiring an assistant Now, I was all hot and heavy to hire an assistant for quite some time. And then I got to the point where I'm like, you know what? No, I'm just going to keep barreling through all on my own. And because I've had an assistant before and I paid someone before to help me, and it's kind of hard if they don't already have the skills or some certain skills. There's this time factor where you have to pay somebody and train them, and then it's like you're like, oh my God, I just blew like, you know, $200 trying to get this person trained, and they're still not quite up to par, and like, how much money am I going to have to spend training this person? You know, you're hiring somebody. And then it's like you're spending all this time training them. So it is important to get somebody qualified. Now, I know some people have like hired people and they just got it right away and figured it out. And yes, there were things that it took them a little while to sort of know, but they pretty much got the gist of the thing right away and were zooming through stuff pretty quickly. And so the help that they were providing was worth the investment. So I'm hoping that it will work out that way with this girl that I am going to have work for me, and so I'll keep you posted how that goes. I got a lot to think about this week. She's going to start next Tuesday, and today is Saturday. And then my son, who I'm always talking about reselling, is at Costco right now with his dad this minute. And he texts me and he's like, I'm getting a pair of shoes for $30. They're a really good deal. And I'm like, you must have I said something like, I think you have a shoe addiction, honey. Which he does kind of have a little bit of a shoe addiction. And I go, and that's okay, because if you're going to have an addiction, that's a good one. And I almost said something about, then you'll know what shoes you can sell. You know, or something like that. But I didn't say anything about reselling. I just was trying to laugh with him. And he goes, Mom, I have money. I'm going to buy 3 pairs of shoes and then you can sell them for me on eBay in the text. And I'm like, oh, wow, that's amazing. That's what you want as a mother. You want to plant seeds. Then let it go, and then the seeds start growing, then you go with it. So, you know, and you want them to decide to do this kind of stuff all on their own. You don't want to push them into it. I think to some degree, pushing your kid into making them do some things is necessary. You know, so you got to pick and choose what you're going to do. But on something like this, I feel like it's important to, you know, he's got to want it. Like, if you're going to do something to make money, you kind of, you know, I mean, we're pretty advantaged. He's in a pretty advantaged situation. So I can't be like, you know what, we're broke, you're working, you know.